I was born in Odessa in 1953, so just after Stalin's death. So it was my happy beginning. Yes, so that I was born after Stalin's death, and I spent my my childhood, my youth in Odessa in 1979. I started to work in Odessa Literary Museum. You see, Odessa spirit is maybe have appeared together with the city, with the Odessa harbor. And it was the time of new ideas, new kinds of life. And this spirit, city of free people, city of people who choose this place for their life, yes, for the oh, due to their own will, and open city, opened to the ocean, a city full of free winds, another place, another space, another cultural spirit. And from the middle of 19th century, more and more authors and even officials and began to connect this Odessa spirit with Jewish people, with Jewish spirit. So in Odessa, Jews were natives. It was the city of immigrants or resettles. And the Jews, together with others, began to build this city and the life of this city. Yes, it was their city. Maybe about more than 70% students of different levels in Odessa, they were Jews. In this period, Odessa took the third place for educational level in the Russian Empire, the after St. Petersburg and Warsaw. And so many educational people, they are people who read. And authors, how came to these places, because they have to be side by side with readers, so close to readers. And Chaim Nachman Berlik, young Jewish poet, Hebrew poet, with first the Zionist ideas, he came to Odessa. In 1881, there was a great pogrom in Russian Empire. And after this pogrom, Leon Pinsker, Leib Pinsker, Lev Pinsker. So he said he had many European name, Leon, Yiddish name, Leib, and Russian name, Lev. So Pinsker, Dr. Pinsker, one of the leader of Haskalah in Odessa, of this Enlightenment movement. And in this moment, he said, that's enough. He went to Berlin. He said, in Odessa, we put stones in the basement of this city with our own hands, he said. But these stones began to cry, go away. These stones, which we put into the basement with our own hands. But at last he have returned to Odessa and organized the first Zionist organization. Of course, they did not know such words, Zionism. They knew, they named themselves Palestinophili, those who loved Palestine, till 1920s. And thousands of people resettled to Eretz Israel, thanks to the support of this committee. In 1922, new Soviet power have closed and forbidden all Zionist organizations. So the activity, the activists were arrested and then exiled to Kazakhstan or Siberia. And so the Zionist movement stopped in the Soviet Union and in Odessa, of course. Because now this Odessa have rather changed in Odessa spirit. And Odessa life now, especially in the period of the war, of this hostile events, it's impossible. It's impossible even to believe that it's in our time. This. And but you know, many of my friends in Odessa, Ukrainians, Russians, they feel that if synagogue operates, that if rabbi have returned to Odessa in this time, it's the chance for the stability, stabilization. Because it's impossible to imagine Odessa without Jews.